moments to settle in, to arrive, to transition from whatever you've been doing in your day. So many possibilities of what that might have looked like. And that invitation to begin to slow down. To get cozy and comfortable as we come into winter time. The invitation is to begin to slow down, although that's not always what happens. But I love the northern traditions, particularly around Denmark, where winter time is honored by spending more time indoors, getting cozy, warm socks and jumpers and fires and candles. And all these things are very nourishing, nurturing for the soul. They're very comforting. How comforting is it to have a warm, cozy blanket and thick socks on our feet? To have soft candlelight rather than bright white light. And to be able to just nest in our place and go with the energy of winter, that slowing down. So as we arrive here, getting cozy and warm, begin to slow down the breath. And without forcing it or straining it, just see how slowly you can breathe in. Almost like a little challenge for yourself. How slow can you breathe in? And then how slowly can you exhale? Inhaling as slowly as you can. And releasing that breath as slowly. Just noticing if there's a tendency or wanting a desire to speed up, to rush. Perhaps you're not even with us anymore in this exercise. Your mind's already somewhere else. How does it feel to slow down? Is it possible? And perhaps this is your favorite. Perhaps we love to take it slow. Just noticing that. A little quote by Terry Gilnett. Winter is the slowdown. Winter is the search for self. Winter gives the silence we need to listen. Winter goes gray so that we can see our true colors. Winter is the slow down, search for self. It gives us the silence we need to listen. Winter is gray so that it shows us our true colors. We're going to start very gently, very slowly, with just some gentle movement. So if you have anything underneath your knees now, just kind of kick it to the side, just so you're free where you are on your mat. And then we're going to take the arms slowly up and extend your legs. Arms are going to float up to the sky above your head. And as you exhale, bring the arms back down, floating them back by your hips all the way to the floor. See if you can slow that down even more. Feel the air moving past the fingers, brushing the back of the hand, reaching all the way up. And exhaling the arms all the way back by your side. Beautiful. We're going to add the feet now. So as we take the arms up, pointing the toes, you get a little stretch through the tops of the feet and the shins. A big yawn. And exhale, bring the arms back by your side. Pull the toes to the sky. One more time like that. Coordinating arms overhead with the inhale, pointing the toes. Slow it down. Notice if you're wanting to go fast. Flex the feet as your arms return to the floor slowly with the breath. We're going to add one more piece. As the arms go up and we point the toes, arch your back. Lift the lower back up away from the floor like you're in a little back bend. And as you exhale and flex your feet, arms return to floor, flatten your back. Lower back presses downwards, belly engages. Inhale, float the arms up, point the toes, arching the back. Exhaling, arms return by our sides. And then this last one, can you go even more slowly? Take the arms up even more slowly. You might even have two breaths to play with instead of just the one. Slowing down, slowing down, slowing down the breath. Don't worry so much about matching the movement with the breath, as long as you're breathing slowly and deeply. Slowing it down even more. And then we're going to rest the arms back to the ground. Just let the whole body settle. Relax the thighs so the feet roll out to the edges of the mat. Now we're going to gather the knees into the chest, bringing one knee in at a time. Little gentle rocks forward and back. Circling around, massaging the back of the pelvis, lower back. Perfect. So we're going to grab our strap now and maybe a pillow or bolster, depending on what we need. So there's going to be two options. We're going to stretch the hamstrings and we can do it the normal way that we would typically do, just hooking the strap around the foot and holding the straps with the hands. But there's another version that I really like, and it's requiring an actual something you can tie and make a loop. So maybe an actual yoga strap would be required for that. And you can loop it and lock it. If you're not sure how to do that, you thread it through both of the buckles together, and then split them in the middle and go back, backwards on itself. So it depends on how long your legs are and your straps are. But before we even attempt to do the next part, we're just going to wake up the leg a little bit. Extend and relax. So straighten and bend. Straighten and bend. Okay. When you feel that you have done that enough, that the leg is willing to stretch a little more deeply, option one, you just hold the straps like normal. Or option two, take the strap behind the head, kind of right at the back of the head. You want to move the buckle out of the way so that the buckle isn't against your head. Maybe you can support your head because your head will be lifted with a pillow or a bolster. This does require a bit more flexibility in the leg, and again, it depends on how long your strap is. You might not be able to get comfortably into a position. But it's nice if you're able to get into it because you don't have to use your arms. And you can completely let the arms go, sacrum heavy. But if you're really struggling with that, just take it away. Hold it as we would normally. And then go back into those slow, breaths. And consciously slowing the breath down. Settling here into the stillness. Maybe the right leg is bent and we like it like that. Maybe we stretch the right leg also down the mat. And then we're spending some time here. Slow breath. Catching ourselves when we're wanting to rush to the next thing. And just savoring this moment. Like savoring a warm drink in your hands on a cold day. If you are using your hands and your arms, keep the shoulders relaxed and soft. Look out for any tension around the shoulders, the neck, the jaw. Go back into those slow breaths. Taking three more breaths here. And then if your strap is behind your head, lifting up your head, resetting down, holding quite loosely the strap so we can make some circles. So start the circles quite small, just stay in one direction to start. And then you can make them a little bit bigger, testing that. So medium sized. And then make them even bigger. As wide around as you can possibly go with the leg. And then the next time the leg comes over to a diagonal, take it across, but just notice which side or which direction you were going with your circles so that you know the opposite way to take the next time. And then take the leg across into a diagonal, pressing the foot into the strap. Find where you need to be with your hands. Do you like to hold it low down? Do you like to hold it closer up by your foot? And feel the difference of those two. Does your hip want to be rooted down? Oftentimes we're told to keep it flat, which for most bodies that really helps, but for some you get a little bit more sensation if you roll slightly towards the right. Establishing where your body needs to be to really enjoy that space. And then go back into the breath, consciously slowing it down again. There's no rush. We have all the time here. Checking in for tension around the jaw, the forehead, the shoulders. one more breath here. And then we're going to take the leg back up to the sky and make your circles in the other direction, if you can remember. If not, it doesn't matter. You can do a little bit one way and a little bit the other way. See if you can make those circles a little bit wider. And then as wide as you possibly can. And then the next time the leg goes to the left, nice and wide, we're gonna hold it open. You can bend your knee here. A lot of people find that bending the knee makes this a lot more accessible, easier to hold the leg. As long as you're feeling an opening through the inner thigh and the hip. You might even use a bolster or a chair if there's a piece of furniture nearby, like this wall. It feels really nice to support the leg. It's not cheating, it just allows us to not have to hold so much the leg. We can let it rest in this open position. Going back to slowing down the breath, quality of breathing. The coziness of stillness. Aligning more and more with the energy of winter, that slowing down, the drawing in. Let's take one more breath here. Then with the help of the other hand, draw that leg back up to the sky. Just a couple more circles, one way and then the other. And letting the leg come back to the floor, let it slide beside the right. That moment to pause, appreciating the difference we're creating. The difference between that side and the other side. And take one more breath here. Then we're going to come into the other side. So bringing your opposite leg up, start with the other knee bent. So you might have the loop, you might just have the strap around the foot. But either way, take a few moments to extend the leg, straighten, and then bend the knee. Just to let that leg be a little bit more forgiving in the stretch. Straightening the leg and bending the knee. Okay, then we're going to hold the leg in the air. And if you're using that loop, maybe lift your head and take it to the back of the head and find something to support your head. So a pillow or a bolster, something that's the right height that you can really rest and relax. So the point of that is just so we don't have to hold or use the arms, but it's completely okay to use the arms too. If you are holding the strap, just be mindful that you're not tensing in the shoulders. Let the shoulders drop back towards the ground. You might wish to keep your left or the opposite leg bent, or you can slide it away, adding a little bit more resistance, a little bit more challenge If that doesn't feel good, just return it. And following that slow wave of breath, filling all the way in the belly, the ribs, all the way to the heart. And emptying out again. Just a couple more breaths here, embracing this stillness for a little bit longer, savoring every moment. And your next round of breath, take an even slower, deep breath in again, and maybe letting the exhale release through the mouth with a sigh. And releasing the strap. And you're just going to start to make small circles. So let's take it to the right first. If you take the leg to the right, and then make some circles right forward, around. And then take those circles a little bit wider, medium-sized. And then even wider, all the way around, big, big circles, as wide as the leg will go and the hip allows. The next time that leg comes over and across the body, hold it there. Hold it across to the left. Hold the strap wherever you need to, close to the foot or lower down. Maybe your left foot or the opposite foot would feel good returning to the floor, knee bent. Sometimes that just keeps a little bit more stability and centeredness in the body. Feel free to play a little bit with keeping the hip tacked on the floor so your back is level, or rolling slightly toward the side and the edge. Let's take one more breath here. Now we're going to come back to center with the leg. And then starting to go to the left first, make your circles again small, left to the side and back around. And then make them a little bit bigger. And then as big and wide as we possibly can. Getting that full motion of the hip. Beautiful. Then the next time the leg goes out wide, hold it there. Maybe there's something we can prop it onto. Maybe a bolster, some blocks, piece of furniture that's nearby, a dog works really well. As long as they don't move. taking a few moments, breathing into that space, go back into the breath. I know stillness also invites the mind to play, our imagination to run free. And maybe that's good. Maybe we enjoy that time to let the mind run loose and wild. Or maybe rein it in by bringing attention to your breath as slow as you can make it from the belly, filling all the way to the heart. Just a couple more breaths here. And then with the help of your other hand, bring the leg back up to the sky. Just a couple more circles here. One way, few directions, few times one direction, then the other way, a couple of times in that direction. Beautiful. And then let's drop the foot, release the strap, slide that leg beside the other, and coming to rest in Shavasana. Letting the body roll open, melting towards the floor. How good does that feel? Okay, so for the next option, either we're gonna stay on our back and do our hip stretch here, thread the needle pose. You can even make that restorative using a wall. Or we're gonna flip ourselves around and come into pigeon pose, maybe with some bolsters or pillows to support the body. So I'll let you decide which one is best for you, either lying on your back, and we'll cross the right ankle over the left thigh. Or come to your front, facing the floor. And let's bring the right knee to the right wrist. Foot and shin across the mat. Don't worry about the props yet. Just find your pose first. Slide the left leg back. And then if you have your props nearby, pillows, bolsters. Sometimes, if you're in the full pigeon, it feels really nice to have something supporting underneath the pelvis. Whether it's right at the middle of the pelvis or just kind of tucked underneath the right hip. Then a pillow or a bolster underneath the chest so that you can turn your head and just rest and melt there. And if you're in your thread the needle pose, is there some support you can take here? Maybe it's a pillow for the head. Maybe it's a pillow or a bolster, even blocks underneath the left foot. Yeah. And if you're on your back and there's a wall nearby, many times we've practiced with that foot against the wall, so it kind of does all the work for us. We don't have to use the arms. In that case. So settling in, getting cozy. Moving towards that winter slow down energy. Inviting it in and aligning with it. For much of our day is misaligned with that energy. Good. Three more breaths here. And I'm going to invite you to take a twist here. So it can be done both ways. If you're on your back, you can drop your legs over towards the left side so that right leg is guiding. And if you're in pigeon pose, we can simply just turn. So if you're using a bolster or a pillow, just turn so that you're gazing towards your right knee. And there's a little supported twist there. If you're not using so much props, you can just come to rest on your forearm, but take a little twist as you lie down. I find it's much easier to twist in pigeon with props. So see if that works for you. Again, if you're on your back, twisting so your legs come to the left, maybe opening those arms in line with chest and heart. And just a couple of breaths here. Returning back to your breath. A slow, deep breath in. A gentle sigh. And returning body back to center. And if you're on your back, just give your knees a hug. And if you're on your front, peel yourself up. Maybe a little child's pose, pulling the hips back towards the heels for a moment. Or if that doesn't feel good, maybe rocking it out in all fours. Even the option of downward facing dog. But whatever we need to do to reset, to find ease for the next side in that transition. And slowly rising back up. If you're on your front, or if you're on your back, left ankle over right thigh. If you're coming into pigeon, come into pigeon first. Don't worry about the props, and then add them at the end. Find the pigeon, find what's right, or finding, if you're on your back, maybe that support of the bottom foot. And this side might require different adjustments or props. Level of props. We hold these poses for a few minutes at a time, so where can we be that is available? And if the mind is wandering, bring it back into the breath. Slow it down. Realigning with winter's energy. Energy of hibernation, of retreating within, of cutting back in simplicity, of reserving our energy. Taking one more breath here. And then I invite you into the twist. So if you're on your back, let your legs drop now to the right side. And if you're in pigeon, lifting up the torso, twisting over towards you, the bent knee towards the left side. And supporting yourself there. Just a couple of moments here, settling back into that stillness. And if you're on your back, the twist can be with bound legs, but it can also be just the traditional with the left leg stacked on top of the right. Just another breath or two here. And then we're going to take a slow, deep breath in. Big sigh. And bringing, if you're in your front pigeon pose, hands to floor so you can peel yourself up. If you're on your back, bringing your knees into your chest. And we're all just going to release that. So whatever that release looks like for you, feels like for you, just moving into the hips, maybe making some circles if you're on all fours, or circles with your knees on your back. And eventually we're all going to come up to our seat. We're going to come to our seat and we're going to come into a Baddha Konasana forward fold. So we'll get the props that we need for that. If you're going to use any at all, always just an option the props are. And sometimes we forget about the props for the knees themselves. So Baddha Konasana is with the soles of the feet together. And oftentimes these bad boys in here are very tight, so they keep the knees from dropping down. So if that's the case, we just want to find something to prop them up where they are so that you can feel a little bit more relaxed in the posture rather than tense, like you're trying to fight something that's happening. So add props there if you need. And then any prop to go forward. It can be your bolster, and the bolster could even be inside of the legs or in between the feet. And sometimes if we're not going very far in the forward fold, just letting the forehead rest on the bolster. And granted, I know we all don't have bolsters, so a chair is a very good prop also to have. In restorative yoga, they use chairs quite often, because then if you have the edge of a chair, you have your legs underneath. And then you can just rest your forearms on the edge of a chair. And if you don't have either of those, you can just lean forward and just let your head and neck relax. If you do have a deeper posture, you can let yourself fold all the way down onto your pillow or bolsters. So just finding what's right and comfortable for you, just for a few breaths. Not as long as we hold the or held the last postures, but for a few moments here, just to let things unravel and unfold, going back into the slow breath. And softening shoulders, jaw, and forehead. And welcoming that silence. For the silence allows us to listen. One last breath. And slow and deep inhale. And a gentle sigh. I'm going to peel ourselves up. Unravel. Beautiful. Stretch the legs out in front of you. Give them a little release and shake. Maybe leaning back into your hands. So our next pose is going to be that heart opening pose, leaning back on the bolsters. So we're going to set up our armchair pose. However you need to set that up, looking to create an incline. So it could be a bolster and a block, could be two bed pillows stacked with maybe another pillow underneath to give it a little lift. And you can always just go flat to the floor with a pillow or something beneath you. It doesn't have to be at an incline, but an incline is a nice variation of that. And we just had our legs open in the Baddha Konasana for quite some time, so perhaps we can skip that for this one. But if you really like that option, You can bring the soles of the feet together, knees apart, but do have props underneath your legs. And this is where it's nice to put the blanket on, close the light down, so that we can really go deep into that restful state. We want to feel that as we lie ourselves back, we're in a slight back bend. Arms can just melt down to the floor, palms up, shoulders back. And depending on your props, sometimes the arms don't feel quite right. Maybe it's too far of a drop. Oh, better. The more things you have nearby at your disposal, the better. Because you can always prop up the elbow and the forearm so that the arms don't hang too low to the floor, maybe just by a cushion or a block. So there's multiple ways that we can adjust this, prop this, refine this. It's really just finding what works best for you. Not being afraid to use support and props. More the better. Check in with the whole body, the lower back, shoulders. And inspired by that quote, the gray of winter allows us to see our true colors. As we lie here, we're going to go through the colors of the chakras, the rainbow body. So one last moment to get comfortable, settled and relaxed. And we're going to start all the way down at our roots. So that can be the roots of the feet. Traditionally, it's the roots of the spine, the very end of the spine, the tailbone, the very bottom of the pelvic bowl. But just bringing your attention to wherever you feel your roots are in this moment. And in the mind's eye, seeing the color of red. And just visualizing red. It can be a red object, or it can simply just be the color of red as a light, as an image, as a glow. Just meditating on the color of red. Letting the energy of red saturate into every pore of your being. The grounding color of red. And red transforming into orange, perhaps like a sunset, you see the many shades of red into orange. Perhaps it's an orange light or just seeing orange objects. Meditating on the color. And then transforming orange into yellow. Meditating now on the color of yellow. Color of yellow taking over and saturating the whole being. Color of yellow, yellow, transforming into green. The yellow transforming into green. The color of green, vivid in your mind's eye. Color green. And green transforming into blue. The color green transforming into a blue. Meditating on the blue color. And then blue transforming into a violet, a purple. Blue transforming into violet purple. Seeing this rainbow within us, all the colors and even the shades in between, this palette of light, color and beauty that dances within us. And see all those colors transforming into a white light, a pure white light, the highest frequency of all. And visualize that white as the white of the snow in the forest, the stillness. The stillness and the silence that gives us space to hear our own thoughts and wisdom. Seeing yourself walking through the forest, this rainbow in the midst of this white forest, and this rainbow of color, walking through this pure white forest. Tuning to the stillness and that slow winter rhythm. Feel your breath attuning to that now. That slow winter rhythm. Imagine that forest one more time, this snow-covered forest. The white snow covering the ground, the trees, the branches. Even the sky is full of white. And coming up to a single tree in the center of the forest. The tree has been decorated with tinsel and baubles of all different colors, reds and yellows and oranges, greens and blues and purples, silver and gold. A beautiful contrast against the white and gray backdrop of the winterized forest. And perhaps in spring, this tree wouldn't stand out so brightly. But now its radiance shines even more. The grayness of winter allows us to remember our true colors. Let's take a nice slow and deep breath here. Breathing all the way through this rainbow body. And a gentle sigh. Wiggle into the fingers and toes. And perhaps a little stretch and yawn. Unless, of course, you wish to stay, you're so welcome to. Bringing your arms back by your side. And just moving your legs to whatever is needed. The knees are bent, maybe a little rock from side to side. If the legs are straight or if the knees are open, pulling them in. And we're going to very gently start to exit the pose, using your hands to catch yourself, tipping over to one side. And coming back up to your seat. And when we get there, just closing the eyes once again, that last and final moment to end the practice. And can we end with a slow, deep breath? Bringing hands to the heart, giving ourselves a great bow. Thank you so much for your practice. Namaste. Thank you so much.